All right, so Big Country Golf is effectively in the beta stage. The engine, I'm sticking to the Big Country Boxing engine for golf. This was something I decided to do for both baseball and golf. The question was, how was I going to score? The score charts, the golf score chart is here and how it works. Then the key, again, I'm a real fan of my Big Country Boxing. I know it sounds egotistic, but there's a magic in how it all plays, but also in the abstraction of boxers having traits, and those traits have a modifier, but those traits just inspire your imagination as to why boxers are winning or losing. If you're using the traits, you don't have to. You can just use an abstract math and roll dice and keep moving on. So, to make everyone aware, this Big Country Golf beta is done, and I have shared this with at least with one person who already again in this Discord group that's been very, very good, and really great feedback from everybody. That's I've already had great feedback on hockey. Hockey's done, but I'm going to make these tweaks to hockey because, again, what's the point in people playing it and seeing some things that I just didn't see? And I'm going to make those tweaks. So there will be an update to the hockey game probably today. I had hoped to take more time on all this over the last for, over the next week, but things have changed in my home life here as we have unexpected house guest early arrival house guest. So I wanted to really so I banged through late into the night to get baseball where it's at and get golf ready to beta. Baseball is for the most part finished. Again, probably there will be some people who don't like the abstract nature of it. They won't agree with how I score the golf or the baseball. But again, these are fictional career games. You're meant to get quick results. You're meant to see golfers engage the course and change over time. You're meant to see baseball teams get scores and evolve over the course of the season. And over the course of their lifetime, legacy teams, winning franchises, losing franchises, etc. And with these charts, like my boxing game, as I explained to Chris when he said, your scoring is a little unrealistic. And I said, that's because it's a fictional boxing game. And of course, that led to me tightening up the professional scorecard for real life boxers. So it was a great conversation, but I wasn't going to change the scoring for Big Country Boxing. It's meant to be weighted the way it's weighted. Golf the same. These numbers are meant to wait for a culture of play that'll, as you play, you're going to learn, how the golfers, proceed. The golf game, of course, has this chart. There's a quick way to roll up golfers super fast, but you won't have ratings to give them a character. And then there's like boxing. You build golfers with four traits. You start with 625 points. You get to roll one time on each of their traits. So trait one is tee box. These are drivers. This is driving. Fairway, which is going to be irons and navigating, or it's mostly navigation. There's greens, which will be putting, and then there's traps and obstacles, which will be special tools, right? And just how well they do. So for instance, I have 625 points, and I roll my lucky day. That means this guy relies a lot on luck, but it's a plus for him. So he'll be up to 630. But then that's how he drives. He gets a good shot and he smiles at his peers and says, "Hey, it's going to be my lucky day." So it'd be a plus five. He'd be a 630. Let's say my next role is caddy's boy. Well, he relies a lot on his caddy when he's on the fairway, getting advice from his caddy. Plus 25, not bad unless his caddy's crap. But plus 25, so he'd be up to 655 already. But let's say the next one I roll is long and wide. You do not want to punt long and wide on these greens. Bad idea. Unfortunately, he's a long and wide punter. Minus 100. He drops to 555. And last but not least, I roll bothered and bewildered, minus 35. So he's now down to what, 4 or 515 or something, 520. And that's his rating. He would be a 5, 20 golfer, and that's where he's set to play. I haven't yet worked out how his career will change his ratings. These ratings, like boxing, never change. This is what identifies these guys for their career. Their rating in boxing changes with every fight. These descriptions never change. It gives you a clue as to what their tendencies are, regardless of their actual quality at the time. Also, golf does something special. Every course, you play against the course, so the course is rated. So you match your golfer up against the course. So this 520 rated player, when he's at Cedar, is going to be at negative 300 and something, and then he's going to roll the negative 300 here for today at Central City Golf Course. What's cool though is also there's going to be special effects. So any golfer on this course that is an avid reader, they're going to get a bonus of plus 10. So let's say I had rolled up here on putting avid reader for this golfer. He would know when he's when, so Central City, these greens are his baby. He knows how to read these greens plus 10, right? But some golfers are going to get negatives, like long and wide. This golfer, the golfer I just pretended to roll up with that long and ride roll, which is going to always be on his card. Well, he's going to hate Newberg because it punishes you bad for long and ride putting. So when he gets here, although it's an easy course, golfers that can place and pop plus 5, they're going to be really good at placing short balls, boom, and then place them again, and boom. But if you're a long and wide a putter, you're in deep trouble on this particular course, right? So all of a sudden, a long and wide putter, this course is a 350 for that guy. So you see now how the course has a rating you match up against, but then there's an adjustment for every course. I include how to design your own course with a quick cheat sheet. Obviously, if I were just, when I finish the full book, all of this will be written and devised a little tighter. This was just a quick way for the beta playtesters to make some courses and mess with the math, right? So again, there are going to be people say, "Wait a minute, you could get worse than this. You could get better than this." Well, not in Big Country Golf. Big Country Golf basically saying the best golfers in the world are going to have minus sevens. So what happens in my sport games that aren't simulating the sport? We're simulating the world. We're simulating careers. Well, you're going to see the culture and those careers play out based on these limitations. My Big Country baseball game is more small ball than juice ball. I mean, you're going to see more dead ball or small ball era type baseball on my scoring charts. And I'm okay with the scores that can occur between winning a game and losing a game, right? So that's golf. And to give you an idea of Big Country baseball, where it's at, big chart. This is a bigger chart because there's a lot more wiggle room for baseball teams. It's a team game. There's set scores. So you're not going to see some certain scores and things, but again, you're going to be able to roll the score of a game. You could sit down and put 25 games on a schedule, and literally 25 rolls, you will rack out 25 games. This is meant to get you to standings, to be moving teams and win-loss up and down the standings through their ratings. And then what is special about Big Country Baseball is teams are going to only change at what's called the mid-season break. There will be a random change to every single team in the league, and that'll affect the rating. And then you can play the second half of the season. At the very end of the season, you will play the off season, and you will roll four new traits. So every baseball team has nine traits now. They have their foundation traits that never ever change, like the golfer I just talked about, like boxing. Those foundational traits never change. There's four of them. That's what sets your team up at the beginning of their career. Mid-season is a trait. And then there's four off-season traits. Those mid-season and off-season change literally every season. Mid-season trait changes every mid-season. The off-season traits change every off-season, and you will see your team, the ebb and flow of teams, go up and down over the course of their careers, their legacies, etc. Again, you'll roll up your team with these are your foundational traits that never ever change. Team will look like this: Unionville Tufts. They're a 600 a rating. They're known for big bats. They're known for their pitching staff yanks them early, so they got a coach that yanks them early. Their bats are drips and drabs. Their fielding is bang bang. These guys turn double plays like nobody's business. Bang bang. They don't have a midseason yet because we've never played this team. We do not have free agency, new blood, training camp, and new roster. Our roster, final roster. I need to change these. These have changed because they haven't happened yet. But once these occur and your first season's gone, you will have these traits which affect this rating up here, and these will change every season. These will never change. And that's what's going to keep changing this score, but keep your teams from going into a negative funk or going into a like 1500 climb. So one of the problems with the war of attrition in boxing, as one of my playtesters, when they first looked at my old scoring charts for baseball, first thing he said was, you know, if you have these teams affected at every game, you're going to get teams that go into a death spiral, can never get out, and you're going to have some teams grow into guys that can never lose. And that's the problem. In boxing, it works because you can retire a fighter and make a new fighter at will. And that makes sense in the world of boxing. Fighters come and go for the era of boxing. Well, teams don't. You know, the Yankees have been around for 100 and whatever years, right? The Yankees aren't going anywhere. But they have to evolve. And that was the magic formula. Realized, wait a minute, I got to stop editing teams. I can't treat the teams like I treat the boxers, right? Because I can literally retire a boxer right now. I can make a new boxer right now. And boom, we're continuing to play indefinitely. So these are the only five that'll change every year, and it will automatically modify whatever their current rating is. So you don't erase these and change the score. You're going to roll new ones, which will affect whatever that current score is. Right, then I have my write-up, like Big Country Boxing. Big Country Baseball, it's going to be a little more epic. I am going to make all 10 teams. I will provide a schedule for that 10-team league. However, the goal is for you to design and make your own teams and your own league. But we're well on the way. As I got all the charts done, I got all the math done, I got all the engine done. What I need to do is finish the teams, and of course, I'll play test this more and make some adjustments to the final math for some of this stuff. So, all right, everybody out there, have a wonderful week. Again, I kind of rushed up. I stayed up late, got up bright and early this morning. I'm trying to get to a place where I can sit on this while I am busy with entertaining friends. And so it is what it is. Thank you. Bye-bye.